just want to make sure you understand, I don't know what the future will be. I'm not psychic. We may kill each other or destroy the environment. It depends on what you do when you leave here. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about the Venus Project if you know nothing about it. Then I want to talk about sustainability, which everybody talks about, but I haven't heard any real description of what would sustain us. The Venus Project maintains that if we declare the Earth, all the Earth's resources, as the common heritage of all the world's people, there'll be no more territorial invasions, no need for armies and navies, no need for prisons or police. This is only necessary in a scarcity-oriented society. We have the technology and the brains today to solve most problems. We have more than enough resources, but we have to do certain things that may not please the establishment. So when the establishment uses the term sustainability, it means for them. So the word sustainability has very little meaning, because everybody, all doctors, make a lot of money treating cancer. So what's sustainability? If you cure cancer, then standard of living goes down. So you see, there's advantages to some people in human suffering. Psychologists deal with people that have problems. But if you raise children in a sane society, there are no problems, except genetic damage. And in that case, they're helped, so there's no problem. Any psychologist that would adjust you to this system has to be stupid. Any psychiatrist that would do that. Any major in psychology is wasting their lives, because many professions are going to be phased out. It'd be very easy to make a lawyer and take about an hour and a half in a laptop lawyer. So if you want any questions answered, that's going to be done in an hour and a half. Medical diagnosticians. People say that deal with skin diseases, like a dermatologist. He looks, when you go to medical school, they show you pictures and in reality, different skin diseases. So you got to remember the images. If you look at a skin disease that's new, you go like that, that means I'm not quite sure what I'm looking at. So you call another doctor, say, what do you make of this? So all you have to do is photograph every known disease and then use a scanner, scan it, and give you the latest treatment. You don't need dermatologists anymore. You can phase them out. So if you're studying medicine, we should talk after the session. So there's a lot that can be phased out. In fact, we can phase out 80% of the professions. There'll be no businessmen in the future if we make the future. There'll be no stockbrokers. They do nothing. They add nothing to the world. There'll be no politicians. Politicians don't know what to do. They're businessmen and lawyers. They have no idea how to solve problems. Don't take my word for it, but ask any politician, how do you prevent automobiles from hitting each other? And I don't know. How do you prevent nations from wanting to kill one another? I don't know. How do you decrease crime? You put up a sign, say no to drugs? That's some idiot wrote that. As long as there's money in it, they'll sell drugs. Hey, you may not agree with everything I say. I want to say this, that human beings sometimes fear machines and technology. It's not technology that pollutes the world, it's man. Men dump stuff into the ocean. Men pollute the air for profit. Men dump waste into the oceans and the fields. It's humans that kill each other, mostly in the name of God. Do you believe in God? Which God? My God or your God? And if somebody else's God, you get shot. So all of you are brought up to believe that certain things work a certain way. That's not true. They maintain control over you by managing news and making you alike. And you keep using the term individuality. There's no such thing. If you met an individual, you couldn't talk to him. You wouldn't know what the hell he was talking about, or she. So So women are given a particular role in this country. When you give a baby doll to a girl, you're already programming her. When you tie a big bow in her hair, you're programming her. So women in the future will pick whatever the hell they want. Electric trains, not necessarily a baby doll. Wiping the baby's ass is no real great career. In other words, they try to get women to believe in having children. You know, children are a pain in the ass most. They're not pleasant. They can't say anything new. They require a lot of your time. You can't travel. You can't do a lot of things. So the population in the future will be diminished. Now, a lot of you believe, well, I like to have my own children. I want my name going into the future. See? Now, if you had a child, say, 11 years old, and the hospital called you, can you hear me back there? And the hospital called you and said, we gave you the wrong child 11 years ago, you're not going to turn it in. Don't you see that all children are about the same? They all say about the same things. And a lot of people think that some children are born lazy, some are born productive, some have criminal tendencies. All that is bullshit. Children reflect their culture. If you were brought up in a world today, say the headhunters of the Amazon, say you were brought up there, if I went into your dad's hut and said, doesn't it bother you to have 10 shrunken heads? He says, yes, my brother has 20. So, is that bad? No, that's normal to where he's coming from. If you're brought up in a Nazi culture as a baby, Heil Hitler, Deutschland over alles, Germany above all, you become a Nazi if you've never seen anything else. So I'm saying no one is to blame for whatever they are. They're culture bound. And all our habits and beliefs are shaped by our culture, even our language. And nobody invented language. And the language we learned in school is thousands of years old. That's why it's difficult to talk to people. Language, and particularly the Bible, is subject to interpretation. When you read the Bible, somebody says, this is what Jesus meant, and another guy says, no, he meant that. And the third person says, you're both wrong. That's why you have Lutheran, Seventh-day Adventist, Catholic, because the Bible is subject to interpretation. So is our everyday language. It's a terrible thing to give people a language that's subject to interpretation. You say things to them, and they come out with something else, totally unrelated, and you think maybe there's something wrong with them. There's something wrong with our language. The big problem is, can we develop a language that's not subject to interpretation? Mathematics isn't subject to interpretation. Structural engineering isn't subject. Chemistry isn't. You talk to a chemist in France and give him a formula, he turns out the same thing. If engineering was subject to interpretation, you couldn't build bridges. Do you understand that? You can handle people if the language has general meaning. That's why lawyers exist. They can take language and twist it around, do whatever they want with it. You can't do that in technology. You can't twist mathematics. You can't twist chemistry. So I'm saying the language we learn is improper for developing a sane society. And sustainability is a word that has little or no meaning. Sustainability to the medical profession is people get sick and they come to the doctor to make more money with it. Well, that's sustainability. But if you make automobiles that are self-repairing, or electric circuits that are self-repairing, the people that repair electric circuits in this system will get mad at you. So it's not sustainability for that. So when you use the word sustainability, what the hell are you talking about? When we use the word in the Venus Project, we mean the well-being of all the world's people, not a selected few. Now we have more than enough energy, more than enough resources, so everyone can live better than the wealthiest people today. I know it's hard for you to imagine because you've never known anything like that. But do you know there's over 2 million cars, automobiles a day outside of factories for 8 hours while the people are at work? What if those automobiles were used by people that came out of the factory and drove them away? You'd have 10 times as many cars available all over the world.